Hey everybody, welcome to Secrets to Short-Term Rental Success, the channel where you can come and find tons of great content on how to be more successful as a short-term rental host. My name is L'Oreal Keaton, and today I'm going to be bringing you five things that you can change right now on your Airbnb listing to help boost you in the search and to get you more bookings and fill that calendar. These are pretty simple tips, but some of them may surprise you. So we're going to dive right into the first one to help you hopefully have more success as a short-term rental host and to get more people looking at your listing and booking your place. So, number one is probably self-explanatory, but I'm surprised at how many hosts do not do this, and that is to completely fill out your Airbnb listing. Make sure that you go through it and fill out every category. A lot of people don't realize that when they go to publish their Airbnb listing for the first time, when you hit that publish button, when Airbnb prompts you to publish your listing for the first time, you're only about a third of the way there. It publishes your listing and it's missing a ton of content and a lot of things you have to go back and fill in. So make sure that you go through your listing and fill everything out. And I want you to pay careful attention to the description. There's a number of categories or kind of subsets in the description part of the Airbnb listing that needs to be filled out. More guests read this than you think, and Airbnb does look favorably on those listings that put a lot of characters into that description. So a lot of words and a lot of content. So when you're looking at your description, the first one is your short description. That is something where I believe you get about 500 words to put into that, or 500 characters. So it's pretty short. You want to be able to describe your place and what is so unique about it, why guests want to stay there, what highlights the property, those special features about it that are unique to other places, or about your location. Anything like that is where you want to put that in the short description. Something that is going to get the guests interested and have them want to keep looking at your listing and maybe read the rest of the description. Once you get below that, you get into the long description, which really you can fill kind of to your heart's content with as much detail as possible about your place and about the location and the area. So you want to make sure you continue to fill that out. And then just make sure that you don't neglect the following other categories that come under the description. There are things to note for your guests. There are things like the neighborhood, you want to fill that in. Also, whether or not guests need a car or can they walk around the area. All of those things are really important. Make sure that they're filled out completely. And then once you've done all of that, it's a great idea to go back and proofread it, send it to a friend, make sure that they can check it for you, that there's no misspellings, that the punctuation is correct. It is really important to present a professional listing. So make sure that you go back and double check that there's no errors in anything that you have written. So tip number one, make sure that you fill out your listing completely. And we're going to get into a few more of the details of the listings as we go, but anything that it prompts you or asks you questions about on that Airbnb listing, make sure that you fill that out. The next one that we're going to talk about, number two, is the cancellation policy. Now, the cancellation policy is somewhat controversial, especially here on YouTube. You can find lots of people with strong opinions about what your cancellation policy should be. And for me, I really just want to say this is something that needs to work for you. I'm not going to tell you exactly what your cancellation policy should be, but I do want you to give it some thought because it does affect how you rank in search. That is something that I don't think a lot of hosts realize, that what you select as a cancellation policy can affect how you book. And you can get more bookings with more flexible cancellation policies than you can with the firm one. So it is just something to think about. Airbnb offers a number of different options. The flexible cancellation policy is a one-day notice. That is pretty tough to rebook if you have somebody that holds your calendar, holds dates on your calendar for weeks or months on end, and then cancels the day before they were supposed to show up. That can be a tough one. That can be hard to rebook. But I will say that if you're in a position where you are in slow season or you are struggling to get bookings and you're not filling your calendar the way you need to, you may want to consider switching to a flexible cancellation policy, because Airbnb actually does give priority to listings that have a flexible cancellation policy. And if you're struggling to get bookings, this may be something that you just want to try for a little while. If your calendar's empty anyway, and a last minute cancellation may not hurt you as much anyway because you weren't getting any bookings, it might be worth it. So just something to realize, the flexible cancellation policy does get boosted in the search results on Airbnb. They also have a moderate policy and a firm policy. And I have heard people talk about how they only have a firm cancellation policy, which is that a guest will not get a refund if they cancel less than 30 days before their check-in. And then they also have the moderate one, which is less than 5 days before your check-in and you won't get a refund. And so it's really up to you, but do your research, look at it, see what works best for you in your market and what is happening, particularly with your listing, and maybe take a chance on something else. Try the flexible one for a little bit, see if it boosts your bookings. And if not, you can always try the moderate. We personally like the moderate cancellation policy. I don't think that it particularly hurts in search results at all. It's not as popular with Airbnb as the flexible one is. But at 5 days out, I think that's pretty reasonable. Hopefully we can rebook in our market if we do get a cancellation. But I think that when guests get through that booking process and they're looking, when they see the cancellation policy, a number of them won't book if they don't have the option to cancel with a shorter window of time. So it is something to think about that really could improve your search and your bookings if you have a more flexible cancellation policy. So that's tip number two and something to consider. Tip number three is your amenities list. You really want to make sure that you have filled this out. And once again, when you first create your listing, the amenities list is quite limited. You have to go back and fill it in when you create your listing. Like once it's published, you have to go back and fill in every possible amenity. The other thing is, if you haven't looked at this in a while, go back and check it, because Airbnb is adding stuff fairly regularly throughout the year, and they'll have different amenity things to check off that weren't there before. And if you have those amenities, you want to fill it out, because there are a lot of very specific searches that guests can do on Airbnb for various amenities like hot tubs or air conditioning, things that are pretty important, but those things guests can search by, and you want to go through and make sure that you have checked off every possible box that your listing offers so that you can have the best chance at ranking well in search. It also is a great way to look at some of the things that Airbnb finds value in that maybe you haven't thought about having in your listing, but that you can add for a really inexpensive price. For example, one that I find kind of interesting is that Airbnb always has listed whether there is an iron and an ironing board at a property. That is something that a lot of guests are interested in if they are going to an event, and they do rank listings more favorably if there is an iron or an ironing board at the property. So you may not have one, but it is a simple thing to get for a little bit of money that you can add and check that box on your amenities list. Okay, tip number four is your photo captions. And this is something that I think a lot of people neglect to fill out. But when you are looking at your photos, when you put your photo reel up on your listing, there is an option to do captions to talk more about the space. And definitely fill these out. We do believe that the algorithm actually looks at the photos and potentially the captions to help in putting your listing in certain categories and such. So not only do you want to use your photo captions to highlight your space and to explain things about your space and different amenities that you have, but you also might want to take some of those shots and talk more about the area and different amenities that are offered in that location. So sometimes I'll take a nice outdoor shot of one of our properties in the Smoky Mountains and describe how close it is to the national park or to the ski resort, and put those things right into the photo caption, and that will also help you in your ranking. So make sure you do those photo captions and fill those totally out. So our last and final tip, tip number five for boosting your listing on Airbnb and getting more bookings, is one that may surprise you and one that a lot of people may not have thought about. For this one, I want you to go into your booking settings, click on that, and then click on guest requirements. And what you're going to see when you open that is there is a little section that says require a guest profile photo to book. Now, recently this changed. It doesn't default to requiring a guest profile photo anymore. It used to. And I used to have to tell people, go ahead and make sure that you turn that off. And this is something that some people may have strong opinions about or feel kind of personal about, especially if you're sharing a space. I think there are folks out there that feel more secure knowing that the person that booked the listing is the one that's showing up, particularly in like a shared home. But the reality is that Airbnb allows anything to be your profile photo. It can be a logo, it can be a picture of your dog, it can be anything. So the profile photo that a guest puts up is not necessarily indicative of who is actually going to be staying at your property. But one thing that a lot of people don't realize is that there is a very large percentage of people that use Airbnb that do not put a profile photo. And so if you don't have it click to not require a profile photo, then your listing is not going to show up in search to anyone that's on Airbnb that just hasn't decided to add a profile photo to their account. So that can be a strong percentage for across all of our properties that we book. I'd say at least 30% of them do not have a profile photo. And you have to think about that, because if you were always requiring a profile photo, your listing doesn't even appear to those guests that are doing a search. So look in your booking settings, make a decision on that as to what is right for you, but you may really want to consider not requiring that profile photo because it's going to rank you higher in search and put your property in front of more potential guests. So that's it for today. I hope that these were helpful to you and that these five simple things will help you to do better as a short-term rental host, get more guests booking your property, and to fill those calendars. Thank you all again so much. Please leave us a comment and let us know what you liked about this video. Thanks so much, and we'll see you next time.